Welcome to this millennium performance by the East Ayrshire Schools Brass Band and East Ayrshire Schools Choir. In May of last year, East Ayrshire Council received support from the Scottish Arts Council National Lottery Fund, and the internationally renowned composer Goff Richards was commissioned to write a piece which would in some way reflect East Ayrshire. Robert Burns' first edition was published in Kilmarnock in 1786, and it seemed wholly appropriate to use extracts from Burns' poetry as the text for A String O Blethers. Preceding the concerts in Cumnock and Kilmarnock was a week of workshops. Sit back, enjoy, and share the experience.
Yeah.
This evening, I have the very pleasurable task of guiding you through a wonderful evening's entertainment by the talented youngsters sitting behind me. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce our conductor for our first piece, when the brass band will perform the Zurich March. Please welcome onto the stage Drew Keechie with the East Ayrshire School's Brass Band. Thank you very much, Drew, and thank you very much, band. That was a wonderful start to a concert, I'm sure you'll agree, with some especially sparkling notes from our two soprano cornet players. Well done. We're now moving on to our second item, and this piece was composed by Vivaldi. He was born in 1675. He was indeed a very prolific composer, and I think suffice to say that he was much acclaimed by a colleague, namely Johann Sebastian Bach. I think that sums up just what a tremendous worker he was in the art of composing. So please put your hands together now to welcome Joe Auld and the East Ayrshire Schools Choir as they perform Gloria in Excelsis Deo. We're now moving on to the next brass band piece, and many composers such as Smetana, Brahms and Dvorak have drawn some inspiration from the traditional Slavonic dances, and no more effective than this next arrangement by Ray Woodfield, namely Cossack Ride and Slavonic Dance. Please welcome back to the stage Drew Keechy and the school's brass band and choir. This next melody rises by step and then falls by step in a most simple fashion, but is extremely attractive. It was made famous by Phil Collins, and please welcome once again Joe Auld with the East Ayrshire Schools Choir to perform A Groovy Kind of Love.
Thank you. That was a very simply melody, but so beautifully sang, and I think I'd like you to join me in giving the choir another round of applause. That was really lovely. Thank you, choir. Our next piece is equally beautiful. It's a wonderful, it's the Irish tune, and it's more commonly known as O Danny Boy. This is a wonderful piece of music, and it's one of these pieces that can send a tingle up the spine. I know it does that to me, and I'm sure it will do that to you this evening. I'd like you to welcome now our conductor for this evening. Very appropriately, his name is Gary Patterson, instrumental instructor, and he comes from the Emerald Isle, so who better to lead the band in O Danny Boy? We're now moving on to our next choir piece, and indeed, Walt Disney has we have a lot to thank Walt Disney for, I believe, in the popular music stakes over the past decade, bringing music from films like Little Mermaid, Hunchback of Notre Dame, and perhaps even Beauty and the Beast. Now, you may believe that I've got a daughter of eight, and that's how these movies trip off my tongue. I have seen them all. And none more so than the next one you're going to hear this evening. It is The Lion King. It's not by the composer of the previous films, not by Alan Menken, but by another duo equally famous, namely Tim Rice and Elton John. So please welcome Joe Auld back to the centre stage to conduct the East Ayrshire Schools Choir singing The Lion King. But just before Joe comes on, I'd also like to introduce our two soloists of the evening, and I'd like to give them a quick round of applause just to get them warmed up for this evening, please. David Burns. And Mark Prendergast. And now the East Ayrshire Schools Choir singing The Lion King.
Thank you.
So please welcome Drew Keachy back to the stage with the East Ayrshire Schools Brass Band and Little Sweet No. 2 by Malcolm Arnold.
Thank you.
Gallop was tremendous. I'm not sure who won, whether it was Malcolm Arnold or whether it was Drew Keechy. I suggest it was neither, and I suggest it was the East Ayrshire Schools Brass Band. Our next piece is by George Frederick Handel, and it's from The Messiah, which he composed in 1742. Indeed, this work is going to be performed in a tremendous venture. You may have already noticed it on the back of your programme. It's going to be performed as a joint venture between East Ayrshire and North Ayrshire on November the 25th in the Grand Hall, Kilmarnock, on November the 26th in a venue yet to be arranged in North Ayrshire, where the choir you see sitting behind me will join with the school's choir from North Ayrshire, a massed choir of over 200 young voices. And we're very pleased that on that occasion, Walter Blair from the Royal Scottish Academy of Music and Drama will be with us to conduct and direct us in that performance. So perhaps that's a date for your diary, and please do come along to support the choir on that day. As a foretaste of that, we're going to perform this evening for you the Hallelujah Chorus. So please welcome backstage Joe Auld and the East Ayrshire Schools Choir.
Thank you.
That was excellent. So hopefully you've all got that date firmed up in your diary now for November the 25th back here for the complete Handel's Messiah with the joint choirs of East Ayrshire and North Ayrshire. Thanks also this evening to our accompanist Fiona McKenzie. I think it's super to hear the sort of music we've listened to tonight, because the young folks have been able to put the correct type of feeling into whichever piece they've been singing, whether it's by Elton John or whether it's by Handel. And I think we'll see that also in our next piece. We've already heard the band playing some lovely slow melodies, and we're now moving on to a very energetic tune indeed. It is the tune which was the theme for many of the Rocky films, and please welcome back onto the stage Gary Patterson with the East Ayrshire Schools Band to play our next number in the programme this evening. Thank you very much. Moving on to our next piece, which I hesitate to call the highlight of this evening's performance, because indeed everything has been a highlight so far. But perhaps to give you a bit of background about the piece, this piece was specially commissioned for the East Ayrshire Schools Brass Band and Choir, and we contacted a very well-known composer, Goff Richards, only just about 8 months ago, to ask Goff if he would do us the honour of writing this piece for us. We were delighted when he said yes, and through support from the Scottish Arts Council National Lottery Fund, we were able to put things into process. I'd mentioned in the programme the word dream, and indeed it is a dream. It's a dream for every musician, every musical group, to have a special piece composed for them, and that's what we're about to hear this evening. A lot of work, though, has gone into producing this music and producing the performance we're about to hear this evening. Away back at the beginning of January, music was starting to come up from Goff Richards, hot off the press, still with the ink wet, and the band and choir worked very hard on Friday evenings during January and the early part of February. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank, first of all, the very dedicated band and choir staff, and also the enthusiasm and talent of the young performers who are members of the East Ayrshire Schools Brass Band and Choir. Moving on from that and moving into this week, Goff Richards drove up from Warrington on Sunday night, and then on Monday he took the first rehearsal with the brass band. That was in Cumnock Town Hall, and that was a fantastic day. We then moved on to Tuesday, where Goff, first of all, had a chance to meet the choir. In this very hall, we had a fantastic day's rehearsal, and things were starting to take shape. And then on Wednesday, the brass band and choir came together for the very first time. Yesterday we had the premier performance in Cumnock, and this evening we're going to have another super performance, I'm sure, in the Grand Hall. For the text of this piece, we wanted to ensure that it had a link with Robert Burns and a link with East Ayrshire through Robert Burns. And Jim Gibson very kindly offered to scan through works by Robert Burns and able to identify specific areas of text that reflected East Ayrshire. And I'm sure that you will enjoy this evening hearing the piece. At the back of the programme, there's a small resume of the text that's involved, and you may want to scan through that. However, please now put your hands together and give a very big welcome to Goff Richards with the East Ayrshire Schools Brass Band and Choir, performing their very special work, A String O Blethers. That was magnificent. It just goes to show that when you mix a world-class composer with a young musician from East Ayrshire, you get one result, and that is absolute excellence. Please join with me. I said that's not the only piece to be performed, and indeed the next piece is also going to be performed in the Dome, so please welcome back Joe Auld and the choir to sing From a Distance.
Distance, the world, the earth, blue and green, and the snow-capped mountains wide. From a distance, the ocean is the stream, and the eagle takes to flight. From a distance, there is harmony, and it echoes through.
This next piece, entitled Irish Blessing, I think is a wonderful piece. It is absolutely super, and the way that the band play it, the smooth melodies. It's sometimes, listening to music, it's all too easy to think that if a melody is slow, it's easy, and if it's very fast, it's difficult. Indeed, that is not always the case, and believe you me, this next piece takes a lot of skill. I heard it performed last night. It was beautifully played, and I'm sure this evening it'll be beautifully played also. So please welcome back to the stage Drew Keachie to perform Irish Blessing with the school's brass band. Music is truly a language, isn't it, that we all understand. And sitting listening to that, I thought it was absolutely beautiful. It's able to touch your heart and affect all our emotions. It really was wonderful, and please thank the brass band once more, because that was just fantastic. It's a tremendous gift they've got, isn't it? A tremendous gift and a tremendous talent. And we're all very proud of these young musicians in East Ayrshire. We've now come to the final item in our programme, and it's become traditional for the East Ayrshire Band and Choir to finish this with this item. And why not? It was composed by another than Ludwig van Beethoven. It's taken from his Ninth Symphony, and it is a superb arrangement of Joyful, Joyful. What better way to end this evening? Brass Band and Choir, Joyful, Joyful.
This is